Hello everyone, Patrick in the channel leave you the comment asking if I can make this type of a chain. I look at the structure, I think this is really interesting surface to show you some advanced Rhino surface technique. So let's get started. When we look at this chain, we want to study the structure first. If you look at the structure, you can see what I did is build a surface, cut out two holes, and blend the surface in between. And we also kind of noticed that the surface that I created has a different depth. So there are some surface editing tools that we will need to use for this tutorial. That's starting from the scratch. Instead of using oval, we are going to use the rectangle tool. Let's right click on very last icon. This one is round rectangle conic corners. Let's go ahead to click on the center in the option, type it 0, and we want to set it up for 16 millimeter. Enter, and the height I'm going to put it like 10 millimeter there. Then we're going to move the mouse coming into the center, and then kind of giving a little bit oval but a little bit corner shape right there. So this is the outline for our link. Let's go to the front view. Now we need to creating a profile right here. Let's use the third one, start direction and start end. We're gonna click on the cosine and cosine, holding the shift, and we're creating this curve. We'll go ahead to rebuild this curve into 7 point with degree 3. And we can kind of move it down to the proper size. And remember the center is kind of caving. So we want to move this center one coming in like this. Now we have this one. We need another one from the other direction. So we're going to do the same thing one more time. Snapping into the quadrant and the quadrant, holding the shift to get this curve, and then we want to rebuild into the 7 point as well. Let's move this down and also move the center down. I also like those two curves is touching each other. So instead of using the control point on, I'm going to use the curve edit point. So let's click on this and hit curve edit point. You're going to notice that now my point is exactly on the curve. We're gonna pick up this curve right in the middle using the move tool to move this one down. Alright, so now we have all the curves touching. I'm going to show you two different ways to make a surface, and let's do the comparison. First of all, I'm going to split the curve that I have as a base into two. So let's use the split command. This will be split by this middle line. And we have this, 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 and on the other direction, we have this one. First, let's use the command is curve network. So we're gonna pick up in the direction and choose this one. And now you will kind of notice that we got this surface right there. All right, let's put it on the side for the comparison. Second way I'm going to make the surface is I'm going to join those two back. We are going to split those two lines into four different line there. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm going to use the command, the same one with the curve network. And we're gonna select everything at once. And notice that the same command that I use, because the curve difference, the surface is different. Let's take a look on this one. You're going to notice in the render view, the one that we work with the first curve network, it seems has a kink or has the point on the surface. And the reason for that is because the way to creating surface has different direction. That's moving the surface to the top. And let's take a look on this curve one more time. Our curve has a direction from the one in the right to the middle to the left, and they need to follow this curve. That's why all the point, it's gonna end up right there. That's because three curve is ending at the same point. On the other way, we are telling it it's go around this curve, but follow the curve coming here and making almost like a rail. That's why you can see it's coming to the point, and the point is right in the center. It's up to you for which one that you would like to use. I personally don't like to have the point on the side, because when you have things on the side, later on, if you want to do the fitted edges, it always causes the problem because everything is right at this point. Another important concept is how we are going to do additional editing in this surface. For example, I'm going to turn on the control point, and from the top view, I do like to have this six of them, and also the same location on the other side for those six of them. And I do want them to go up a little bit higher, so that way it can create some sort of a bump. Notice that the way I creating this bump, it's because I only dealing with those 6 or 9 point. It's kind of giving me a dramatic change on the curve. It looked like you got mosquito bite. So that is not good for our surface. I'm gonna go back one more step. Let's take a look on this command. It's called soft move. We want to select everything first and deselect all the points on the bottom that you don't want them to move, and deselect our object. So all we need to have is the control point. Now let's go ahead to use the command soft move, typing soft move at the command bar. Going to where that you are going to have a bump. So roughly I'm gonna say here. And then that's giving a radius of what is the boundary of this move. And then let's take a look on the right view. We're going to slightly raise up in this way. And it will give you like a diagram of the bump. You hit enter. Then you're going to see it has this type of a bump there. And if that is the bump that you want, let's just go ahead to move on to the next step. Align from the center, and I will use the trim command to trim the bottom half, and I'll simply just mirror this to the other side. Don't forget to join it. Alright, so once we are done, we can actually mirror this guy to the other side and join it together. Or this link. So far it's about 4 millimeter thick, and then if you think that's too thick, you can go ahead to 1D scale it down to make it thinner. I simply just gonna snapping into the quadrant, making a circle and moving the circle inside of the shape. Simply mirror to the other side. This is going to be the holes we're gonna cut it out. So let's pick up the trim command. Pick up those two curves and trimming things in the middle. Alright, so now we have these two openings there. We're going to use the blend tool, and we're gonna pick up the chain edge. Make sure auto chain equal yes, and we want to pick up the first one and the second one. Then let's lower down the number. And you can also lower down a number together if you click this lock, and you can move down those two sliders at the same time. After preview to look if that is what you're looking for. And since this is symmetrical, I can just simply or mirror to the other side and join everything together. So now you have this chain. And again, this may not be look exactly like the first one I built, but you get the very simple idea. And then if that is too thick for you, you can simply just 1D scale to make it lower and to see whichever that fitting into your design. I hope you enjoy the video. Let me know where you're coming from. It's so nice to meet all of you online, to knowing that my video is actually helping a lot of people all over the world. That give me the courage to continue making the video. Have a great day, and I'll see you next.